OG.
In a similar vein, I feel like a CK can really quickly burst out a Razor before you can get the static link off, right?
Good point. Still a bit of regen left, but no tell with plenty of mana and some out, lots of damage to go around. Oh, they're going to go for Taiga. 1 second stun, though, is going to allow Taiga to get off the fairy fire. No tell can't close the gap in time.
Okay, now it could be that they get a counter kill on Samael. Samael needs to get away. Reality Rift, but he didn't get a crit there to heal. No tail will get a counter kill on Taiga, but that is not the first blood. Huge win there for Liquid. However, No Tail actually cleaning up the space. He wants a lane to himself.
Looks
bottom lane, Samael sees a squirrel. Wants to kill the squirrel, but here comes a Mars. Boxy surprised them. They have Arena Blood still available. Samael could be in trouble. They actually spear him to the wall. Again, stole the arena just in case, but Samael gets saved with a cold embrace. Boxy doesn't want to let this target go. Samael needs to go up to the high gun. It's impossible for him, so he's going to fall.
Already coming top.
Oh, he is coming top. Okay. So, yeah, because they got the rotation first with Mars. Puck couldn't do the same thing top. So now you have to try to do something big top to kill Illidan because you only got a support out of it. There's the Reality Rift plus the Chaos Bolt. Illidan could be in trouble. Stops and joins. Stream Call still hasn't been used. Illidan is going to fall to Thompson. Nice little kill there. And this can result into a tower, that'd be ideal, but maybe Sepp just wants to go bottom to... Alright. Take the... He took a small lion kill, it's not that big a deal because Timbersaw managed to stop this push down bottom, and as you can see, Quake was just now cutting lanes, recovering. This is the flash farm we're talking about. Not the ideal situation for Broodmother, but a situation that is okay and acceptable for Quakeva, and a way to recover and still put pressure. In the same way, Liquid is going to respond to OG by trying to go up top and preventing them from taking an easy tower. After all, the Razor versus CK matchup does benefit the Razor ever so slightly. Taiga, however, won't be benefited by this too much. It's Fate's Edict, and he's a Scurry already. Dream Gold just for Insania. They use the Winter's Curse to get rid of the Razor, and Insania should die. That no! With a pushback, Insania's fine for now. And in fact, Illidan is going for the Winter Wyvern, trying to kill No-Tail. He is going to get that kill. He stole a bunch of damage, has the magic wand. Illidan trying to get away.
Fox
here comes
here.
Fox to help him out the arena, just a bit late. Face shift avoids that spear. Thompson is fine for now. As I haven't lose rope just yet. Waning rift to the high gun. Thompson needs to avoid more damage. The healing from the purifying flames is keeping him alive. Thompson going up to the high gun. He wants to get away, but will he succeed? He might just have to consider suicide. And he's not even going to get it. Thompson will die to Insania's auto attack there.
Yep.
I think Liquid is responding accordingly. They're still finding farm for Boxy, which is going to be the main space creator in the early mid game. And then by Illidan just staying top, this tower won't fall. That's as much as he needs right now. Eye of the Storm is ready in a second. He's stolen a bunch of damage. Dreamcall, though, they don't care for the stolen damage. He's going to burst them down. Yep. If you can't attack, what's the point of the static link? That's what OG's discovered. And Koika is playing a bit more active. Broodmother not staying in the bottom lane. Wanted to put pressure mid as well. Timbersaw didn't quite cancel her entirely in the early game. She still took the
They're
tower.
Making another play top. Illidan with the link onto Soxa. The arena's erected. Only catching Sumail in it. Illidan with a 40 damage stolen or thereabouts. Sumail attempting to TP away. It's the Hex for Taiga to stop a stun from coming through, but they didn't need it. Illidan with plenty of damage already. Soxa with a nice juke here. It does manage to avoid the bushwhack. There's one thing that Timbersaw is afraid of. After trees, it might be spiders. Fights breaking out in the mid lane. Finger of death for Boxy. They've nuked him down. Winner's Curse here on a Koikva. Only one creep to surround him. The stun is 3 seconds onto him. Sharpshooter, though, is going to pick up Soxa. Embrace with the by the Wyvern. Koikva has got plenty of healing. Insania as well, still holding on to the False Promise here, as now Koikva turning and murders No Tail. Doesn't get much lifesteal off, but now Sumail left behind here could be in trouble. Koikva, though, returning, realizing that Seb's TPing on over, doesn't want any trouble. Bushwhack at least holding down Seb. It was Thompson in the face of Illidan.
I feel like Liquid is taking advantage of OG's indecision with their movement sometimes. And Liquid's always there to punish that. Of course, Illidan just leading. Go for Seb. Now Taiga could be in trouble. Using the False Armor to save him, but Winter's Curse to reset this fight. Can they continue? It's OG.
No arena.
Go in. Boxy's ready. No arena, though. They're going to burst down Illidan. At this rate, he's been hexed. They turn him into sushi. Illidan will fall.
Spiders are coming.
Kind of a freebie there. Taiga does bushwhack Thompson. Do they have the damage to kill him? They do with a sharpshooter. Taiga just had it ready there. As Seb trying to run away, trying to save No-Tail, but the spiders end up finishing him off. A nice little Fortune's End, pretty long duration as well, but Spear wasn't ready to push him back just yet. Koikva trying to find the supports, but he lost all his spider army. He just got new ones off Sox's dead corpse.
That is the vessel already completed here for Taiga. Boots into the vessel, and now Illidan coming back. We fighting, boys? We fighting. onto the other side of the river, though, and despite having the vessel, debuff applied, Seb should still be able to stay alive for now, but Boxy looking to change that. Sharpshooter perfectly calculated, will find him. No Tail without a Cold Embrace is going to die to the Spiderlings, if not Boxy, trying to at least get the Spiderlings to get the kill. No such luck. He is going to go down to the auto attacks of Taiga, and it's Liquid who actually take the mid-tier 1 tower first. Seb? Okay, you hit for the Yule Scepter of Boxy. Arena walls are erected, and that will leave Seb in a very bad spot. The break in case they needed it. Winter's Curse again from No-Tail does not connect onto anyone. Only holding down Illidan for a second and a half is now No-Tail attempting to TP away. Just way too much burst damage. The physical damage insane right now out from Koikba.
Top.
Oh, there it is. Yeah. Soxa yet again, unable to blink away. Will be killed off pretty easily by Boxy. He's got Blink and Yules now. I think I like this as a solution. I feel like for a lot of the Mars, usually you'll see one or the other. But he's been having, honestly, a pretty good game. He's third in terms of net worth. And we do need as many resources as we can get, especially early on, to try and stop Thompson from just, again, having a free game. So far, I'd say that they're quite successful. 5-3-2 right now on Thompson as we look over towards the mid lane, where Seb is going to turn and just get all the spider lanes, leaving only one alive with the Crimson Guard active. Denver chaining his way around. Boxy, though, is going to be able to find No-Tail. Arctic Burn active, but shot down there with the crossbow bolts of Taiga.
Still
smoke. Liquid are going to be heading back into their own jungle where they see Thompson. Aegis still available though for another minute. Yule Scepter boxes Yule himself. And now Seb on the way in. They almost get through Insania. He does manage to at least pop the ultimate onto himself before the finger could kill him off. Taiga finally with the kill onto Soxa. Illidan though with the BKB now held down by the Winter's Curse yet again. Seb still looking for these backliners along with Thompson as the Maelstrom procs out from the Acorn shot doing a bit of work. Illidan, though, getting focused as he's been kited around by No-Tail. Sumail throwing the 3-second stun on top. Thompson as well, closing the gap. Bushwhack not finding anything as it's going to be Illidan instead taking the drop. Taiga held down now in place by the Dream Coil. Ought to be finished off here, but just with the right clicks alone. Seb with the Timber Chain able to get the job done.
And that pretty much gave him the team fight to me, honestly. It was the two Lotus Orbs. And now Thompson is even more free than before. He's going to go for the Kai and Satan, so starting to actually build some items that will give him some damage. Insania. Does the ward. Now he's technically invisible, but Seb has so much area damage, he doesn't seem to care. They will kill the courier on top of that. Winter's Curse for Illidan, but here comes Boxy. The slew of stuns for Illidan, who has the BKB. No-Tail is in trouble. He's going to come out of this ice with a headache. Illidan will finish him off, and Sumail wants to continue fighting first on Illidan with that. However, Sumail just kills him. A big spider and a Spartan is trying to go after Sumail. Can they do so? They did break the Dream Gold. They didn't know it was an axe on it. So Quiggle gets stunned for quite a while, but same with the False Promise. Now the Hex instead for Insania, punishing him for his sins. Liquid will end up losing three.
The Acorn shot. There's a couple of procs off from the Maelstrom.
Bushwhack actually catches the illusions. Good Bushwhack. But I still think these racks will fall. Sumail. We'll end up taking this one lane of rack, Seb. No, no, hit it. Nice, hit it. There we go.
Bushwhack.
Seb gets stuck to a tree, but it's fine. We're good. He can get away. He also has the Kai and Sign, so he's pretty safe.
He's trying to cut off a backliner here. Instead, he's going to be punished for this one yet again. This time, though, he's not going to look to snap the coil, but Sumail's going to snap his neck. I don't know if spiders have necks, but... Ask Sumail, he's just murdered Koikva. Arena set up though, Thompson too fast on the phase shift. And now Illidan was expecting that one to connect. He's got a BKB just to run away. OG though, their foot's on the gas. They're not letting up here as now Insania back onto the low ground. Sumail trying to pull someone out of position here, just needs the vision. Will settle eventually for Boxy, who now pops his BKB, but Illidan hexed up. Soxa on the high ground, removing him, slowing the mana, or slowing the Razor tree, and held down now about the Bushwhack. Liquid just looking to buy themselves enough time to escape, but OG yet again going aggressively. The coil finding both supports. Seb diving underneath the tier 2 tower now. Plenty of damage. Sumail onto the back lines with the Phantasm active as Illidan looking to try and do the same here to Soxa. Sumail held down a bit by the Bushwhack as there's going to be now the False Promise used on Insania. Sumail has dispatched at least of Taiga. Koikva is going to be eluding the fight, but lane. Sumail and Seb onto the tier 3 towers. There goes Insania.
And they forced Illidan to TP back home there. Sumail wants more kills. He has a Blink Dagger and a 4. Boxy also wants these kills. Oh, look at the Lotus Orb! That sets up yet again Boxy in trouble. It's once more Seb with a split second Lotus Orbs. Getting a kill he had no right to there.
There's Sumail now.
There's a smoke here.
Heart of Tarrasque for Sumail.
Okay, Taiga. Trying to kill the lion first. Oh, not in the middle of Aeon. That's not what you were looking for. Bloxy still has the arena of blood.
Got Thompson this time.
Out of it. Upson's save. They're gonna kill Notale first, but Illidan is in trouble as well. Samael just pummels him to death. Bloxy's the next target. They silence him and crush him. They've just taken two cores out of the fight. It's only a big spider left. What is she going to do? First, they go for Insania and Taiga. They leave Quakeful alone. The spider's been leashed. The GG is called. Liquid has had enough. OG will take game number one in a very deciding, very impressive fashion, honestly. Destroy the puck. Razor go against the TA.
No problems, boss. You're going to need more level than that. Soxa in a bit of a struggle top lane, though. No longer has Icarus dive because he's maxed Fire Spirits instead. And using the Slytherin Crush as well as that line stun, they will be able to set up for a kill in the lane. Well, cheeky.
The one thing that this lane of Sara versus TA honestly seems quite strong with an IO on top of it. I feel like Phoenix can do a bit here because reducing attack speed obviously very big against a Slardar. Early on, just punish Samael for his low range anyway, until you grab like Dragon Lancer. Yeah. To the point, it was that if you're up against a melee core, sometimes you can just max the melt or even put a couple points of melt, punish him. You can't do that against Slardar. You can't use the sideways effectively. Middle lane, by the way, Quakeful. And even the creeps are helping him out. He wants to get the kill before he dies. He will accomplish that, but Quakeful will fall to Thompson. Close though. Almost got that second kill as well.
Oh, Razor. Yeah, could be Razor. I think it's probably Razor. I mean, is it?
Never considered that option before, huh? Soxa might just die for free. Yep. Quakeful, honestly, is the second time they just deliver food for Liquid. This time Soxa was walking by, Quakeful was taking stacks. And because you've also rotated him top, I mean, TA had to leave, because if she stays there against the Slaughter, she dies. But if she goes against Slash, she dies. If she goes against Razor, she dies. It's tough. She's just gonna have to go for the jungle, Seb. Acting in that hood, not gonna help against Ibalic Edict. They're just gonna chase him down. Goodbye. Illidan is having a blast right now. Bloxy himself seems to be rushing the Ags. Yes, he is. Stampede mid. But Quakeful is not a target you can kill. In fact, Samael might be in trouble. There's a relocate coming here. Yeah, they know the relocate. Illidan wanting to just send out Thompson. They broke the coils there. Everyone got stunned. But it's actually Thompson who's in trouble. Last Illusory Rope will get him away. Finger of Death will finish off Notale on the backline. Samael's being chased down. Quakeful slowing with a plasma field. Bloxy, he's in the water. He's too fast. Run, Samael. But the bash will cancel him. OG will lose two.
Most of OG actually, we're all meandering their way down bottom. Illidan might be in a bit of a rough spot. We've got Relocate ready to go as Illidan with the Yule Scepter, setting up for the kill onto Seb. No Stampede for another minute. Oh, nice Fortify into the creep wave, though, is going to prevent the Edict explosions from doing too much damage. Illidan juking them out quite a bit as there's the Relocate out. They've silenced the Wisp, though, and now with the Supernova on top, Taiga is going to have no choice but just to look at the sun and die. Thompson with the kill there as they now look back for the one onto Illidan. We'll be able to secure that. Kills for free. Samael, by the way, with a Blink Dagger and Dragon Lance. Next into the Desolator, so he's going for the full trio of items here.
Okay, Samael's near Illidan here. Nice Yules to avoid the meld, but he could still be in trouble. Hookshot with the cogs. He's stuck. Illidan will die first. And they're going to kill Bloxy. Oh, now with the relocate. They save him from the Supernova. Dream Coil still catches him. Bloxy just wants to get away. Bloxy. As it break the Dream Coil, he lost Taiga though in the back lines. Bloxy's still trying to fight, but it's so difficult to get in against OG. Well, that's some strong 5-on-5 fight. Taiga did buy back for this. Going for Seb. Difficult target to kill. Razor might just get the cogs, close him in. And it's going to be Quakeful finishing him off there. As Thompson trying to walk away. They do see him, but it's a little bit difficult to get him.
Yeah, for
still
sure.
A win for OG, honestly, even if they lose the Centaur there. Forcing the buyback was a big deal.
It's a big win. It's definitely a big win. I can't believe that they managed to make a play like that. Liquid with a good save, and I have to commend Insania, even though he does die, he gets a crucial hex immediately off onto Thompson. The teamfight looks so bad for them there if he's able to actually get that coil off just a couple of seconds earlier, because Taiga was still in the channel, or sorry, in the cast animation of Relocate. And had they canceled that, they would have lost Bloxy 100%, and then they've got absolutely nothing to fight with. Notale's a little bit early here, unfortunately, on the way in. Illidan's melting him, but the Sunray is too much damage. Down goes Notale. He's going to buy back immediately. Thompson's hit with the Hex, and now the Finger of Death will finish him off. Seb, though, is able to snatch up the Aegis and even the kill onto Illidan. He'll lose it immediately as Liquid look to claim the second life wrongfully taken from them. They feel, anyway, plenty of damage now onto Seb, but Sumail starting to pump in some damage of his own, is able to get a kill onto Insania before he blinks out of the river. Koifa, he's going to chase after more with a Static Link now onto No Tail. No spells available, and now Yule Scepter, he's got absolutely no recourse here. He will end up dropping.
Yeah, I agree. I think you just, that team fight gave you the chance to do this, but Liquid doesn't want to give any more chances. They have the blink on Slaughter. Go for Soxa first, at least get rid of that Supernova.
Oh, nice.
Nice Slithering Crush, prevents the Icarus dive. Kill on Soxa matters here, because that means no Supernova.
A lot
of Liberty going to more fights. Thompson does get a two-man Dream Coil. And he goes for Illidan first. Taiga in the tree, still has the mech heal with the tether. Illidan gets immediately healed by that mech. Doesn't really matter. Look at that. They run down Illidan. Thompson gets a valuable kill here on Illidan. Resets this, but Liquid still looking to fight.
They
hold the high gun. Koikva nearby. They have the haste. Hex Sumail first. Taiga joins Boxy. The true carry. Miss Slithering Crush. It doesn't matter. They kill off Sumail. Thompson in trouble as well as Boxy reveals him. Thanks to that gross haze. Thompson, where are you going to go? Boxy just wants the stun. Plasma Fuel might just catch him. He is being seen right now. He has to TP quickly. Koikva has a Yule Scepter. Will cancel that TP. And Koikva will get close and personal to see him die.
Be sneezed at. Now bottom though, actually, Insania will TP in, and they've caught Thompson here. The Stampede, that is a fast fish. That's gonna allow Thompson here to escape. Illidan thought about going for more though, as now it's gonna be OG's time to turn. The Yule Scepter though is gonna manage to dodge at least Dream Coil. Supernova though on top. Boxy trying to get rid of it because it's inside of the cogs, but he can't quite get the job done. Illidan's dead. Taiga, and now Boxy is to fall. So he wants to be able to land these silences. Yeah, so. It's still quite a ways away, but he's committed to it early. Great.
What an Earth Spike
from Insania. Boxy immediately here on top of Thompson. They've got the kill with the Finger of Death. No Tail now in a terrible spot. Cogs are not going to save him for the magic damage of Illidan.
Yeah, it could be for the Lion IO to prevent the relocate saves. Yeah. That's actually a good idea. Okay, wait. Talk about Lesh. They're going to burst him down. Mech, never mind. Illidan survived this split Earth.
Wait, they reload him out.
The relocate. They saved him. They reload him out. Illidan couldn't continue that follow up. And now Illidan will just die to Samael's attacks. That relocate. It punished both of them at the same time. Thompson's timing is always on point though. Ags right as the mech spike comes out. Sorry, Ags right as the BKB spike comes out is very important. Koikva. Okay, he's in the right position. Doesn't seem to matter for Seb, who just goes in. Can they burst him in time? The IO's gonna try to heal him, but he's been silenced. They want to kill the IO first, and they'll accomplish it. Goodbye to Taiga, as Insania is also bursted down. Supernova in the middle of this. How are you gonna save yourself? There is no relocate, so Boxy will fall. At least Illidan had the Bloodstone to survive a bit longer. Seb went ham, did stun Taiga a second time. That's a dive back for Taiga. And Samael still wants Illidan's life. Good Yule Scepter to avoid the melt damage. In fact, Sumail could be in trouble now. He's been done.
Yeah.
Goodbye to Sumail. His team couldn't follow up. They weren't fast enough. And now it's Liquid on the prowl for more kills. But OG will TP in time.
No.
Thompson might not be as fast. He's still looking for the kill on Illidan. They have caught Seb, but Illidan dies in the mid lane. Seb has to run away. Won't do so successfully. Another loss for OG.
Going on to Pops.
Insania hoping to turn this into a kill on Thompson. Soxa. Still nearby. Boxy. As the Corrosive Haze, hoping to kill Soxa, waiting for that Blink Dagger, but they hit him with a Spirit. Soxa just giving some time. No Tail comes in with a hookshot and the cogs. Boxy's stuck in the middle of this. Insane is going to die to Thompson. Boxy has been slowed. He can't get to the cogs. He's too fat. He's out of the water. They can hurt him harder. And now Boxy will fall. That's a dieback Razor. Also in trouble is Thompson. The man has not died, and he wants more. Koifa does have a haste rune. There's a team behind Thompson, and a Dream Coil available yet again. Where are you going to run to, Koifa? He's just going to fly up in the air, comes down with broken bones. OG will finish off Liquid multiple times here.
Just looking to keep Liquid locked in and choke them here. Boxy in a position here, actually timing it perfectly with the Aegis expiring, but Sumail will blink out. And now No Tail will be left behind with the cogs, hookshotting forward to make sure there's no chance.
Getting rid of the clockwork is important, as we've seen. You talked about the hookshots last fight. But OG is going for the SEA smoke, yeah. We lose one, we kill one of yours to even it out. Let's see Koikva, the target first, the hex on the Thompson. But there is Sumail to protect him. They kill the lion. Very important. That's your main source of catch. OG can chase after them with a stampede. They're going for Koikva. Sumail is just fighting Boxy head on. There's a supernova in the high ground. They can't get to it. Taiga and Boxy will both fall. The supernova will end up stunning both the remaining cores. Lash tricks down for the count. Koikva will join him in the grave. even the Static Link doing nothing there. Everyone is down for Liquid.
Insania as well, I don't think was expecting the rest of OG to be prepared to fight behind him. But they pick up the DD rune and immediately make good use of it. And in they go immediately. TA, Ags, and Inceptor, by the way, on the way for Sumail. As the first of two tier 4 towers will crumble. Boyfo's gonna buy back. Insania, next time of the stun of the Centaur, jukes as well. The no-tell hookshot tops in. With the blink on in, along with Seb. They almost get the kill, and in fact, they've got him. It's gonna be now no line for 45 seconds. As the throne already under attack, OG refusing to go out here in the first round, but Koikva looking to at least make them work for it. Pops the BKB, sapping the damage now from Sumail, but not fast enough. Sumail into the melt, he will go with the bash and the hit onto Razor. He will end up going down. Now starting a mad fight here versus Boxy with another crush, though. Actually gets Sumail quite low. Sumail is about to drop, and down he goes, dead for 2 minutes. Illidan doing, that's Illidan doing as much damage as he can here in a large AoE is going to be able to force them back. No-tell hit by the bash now, courtesy of Boxy. The Topsid looking to try and punish him. The hookshot as well will find Taiga. Illidan completely out of mana now, can't do much using the last bits of mana. Try and get this kill onto No-tell. As now Seb is still looking to try and lock down Illidan and Taiga, getting the kill there with the double edge, but they've managed to land the finger and now the Hex onto Topsid. Supernova Sun is going to come out, though, onto Illidan. Forced to use the Yule Scepter, but the GGs have been dropped. OG will prevail. Moving on to the next round.